Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and today I'm back with some fun with foiling. I will be working with the latest kit by Spellbinders. This is the hot foil kit of the month. And first of all, let's take a look at the foil roll. This is the blush color. And then here are the plates as well as the dies that you get in your set. So the main foiling plate in this kit is the word thanks. This way you have a sentiment as well as a big focal point for your card, and it has a lovely decoration of leaves as well. You also get four different secondary sentiments to go along with the big thanks, such as a million, for all you do, you are the best, and finally, for your kindness. And you can also decorate your world with leaves and flowers. In the set you get both dies as well as foiling plates so that you can create your own flowers and leaves with a little bit of foiling on top of them. Now I have a 4.25 by 5.5 white cardstock here and I'm going to place my word thanks on top. If this is going to be your final panel, then maybe it is a good idea to make sure that this is nicely placed and just tape it down with some washi tape. I don't really care about the placement here since I will be working with a die later on to cut that out. So even if it is a bit wonky, it doesn't matter. But I'm going to show you how you can work with it if this is your final panel. So I made a hinge with my washi tape and then underneath I placed a piece of my roll and always make sure that the pretty side is touching the foiling plate. Now you also want to chop off any excess. You don't want to have too much of that foiling or you will get some overfoiling all around. Although this is not a problem, you can easily erase it. So I have everything down and I'm waiting for my timer to stop blinking, and once that's ready I can add on top my two seams. Today I'm going with both this one because I like to press the plate on top of my cardstock even more. This way I get that emboss effect that I absolutely love along with the foiling. So now this has stopped blinking, which means that my plate is nice and warm. I'm going to place the two seams on top, pick up the whole platform and run it through my die cutting machine. I like to do that a couple of times and I'm doing it quite slowly. So I give enough time for the plate to press the foil on top of my cardstock. I am also going to place that platform back in the dock. This way it is ready for the next foiling that I'm going to do. And here is the result, absolutely stunning. Now since I have my platform here and it is ready to go, I'm going to do some more foiling so I have all the pieces ready to decorate my card. Now I'm going to go with a secondary sentiment for my card, so I'm going to place that down and I will foil that on white cardstock. The sentiment I picked up out of the four secondary sentiments is the one that says for all you do. So I'm going to cut out a thin strip of the foil and now I have all the pieces that I need. I'm going to do the same thing for the flower and the leaf. So I'm going to place the plates down and for the flower I'm going to go with a little bit of pink cardstock and for the leaf of course I will go with green. And now I'm going to cut out little pieces of foil, place them on top of the plates. Always remember, pretty side touching the foiling plate. And then on top I'm going to place the cardstock. I have also pressed the timer and I'm waiting for that to be ready and stop flashing. And then I'm going to create my sandwich one more time and run it through my die cutting machine. I really have a lot of fun when I'm playing with my foiling machine. I find that the results are absolutely stunning. They look really professional. So let's peel off the backing of these ones and you can see the result. Here is a part of the leaf. I need to use the die to cut it out. Here is my sentiment, all foiled and beautifully shiny. And here is the leaf. Again, I will use the die to cut that out. I repeated the same process and I also used extra dies to cut out leaves and flowers from different colors. You can see I have picked and white here. And I am going to place a rectangle die. This is one of the dies that have some stitching all around. I'm going to place it down with my washi tape and cut it out. This is going to give me a smaller panel than the standard card, so I can use some foam tape at the back and pop it on my card base. This way I get some dimension, which I absolutely love. I always feel that the dimension gives something extra on my cards and make them look more special. Now I'm going to put my flowers together. Some of them are made to layer, but of course you can use them separately if you like. You can stack them up, you can use gradient colors. I went with pink and white on top. And when you stick the smaller piece on top of the foiled flower, you will still be able to see the foiling on the first layer. I'm using my Studio Katia wand here. This is really handy to pick up tiny little pieces. And of course my trusty Nouveau Deluxe glue. Now the idea is to create clusters of flowers and leaves, and I will create three of them. So for the main flower, I have a foam square at the back to add dimension. And I'm going where that foiled leaf is. This is where I will create my clusters. Now underneath I'm going to tuck some more of the flowers that I have cut out, and everything else is going to go flat directly on top of my card panel. These are the leaves that have some foiling on top, and I'm spreading them out so every one of those clusters has at least one of the foiled leaves. And then I'm going to tuck underneath more flowers and leaves. If you are into foiling, I think this plate is really lovely because you can create really elegant looking cards in no time. You have the sentiment and the focal point at the same time. And if you want to make it even quicker, you don't have to cut out your own flowers. If you have any tiny little paper flowers on your stash, just stick those on top and you have a card in pretty much no time that looks really special since it has that foiling on top of it. Now you can play around with different color combinations of the cardstock. I went with white cardstock, but you can go with pretty much any color that you like at the background. And then you can play around with the different colors of flowers that you add on top. Now I want to help my sentiment pop even more since this is white on white. So I'm going to bring in another die that is slightly bigger than my actual sentiment strip. And I have a piece of scrap white cardstock here, which I'm going to add on top a piece of double-sided tape. I'm going to place the die on top and run it through my die cutting machine. And this way I created a rectangle piece that when I peel off the backing of that double-sided tape, it is super sticky. And here is another way to use the foil roll that you have in your kit. So all I'm going to do is to cut out a small piece of that foil roll and then place it on top of my sticky scrap piece of paper. Make sure that it's nicely stuck there. Use the back of your scissors, your fingers, doesn't really matter. As long as this is nicely stuck there, peel it off. If you have areas that haven't been foiled, just go back with your foil and cover them up. So this way I ended up having a piece of cardstock that it is matching the foiling of my sentiment. And I'm going to place the sentiment on top of that, which is going to give a lovely border all around. And this way it's going to help my sentiment pop even more against the background. For putting those two pieces together, I just use my Nouveau Deluxe glue. I'm going to cut off the excess paper. And now if you notice, I have already added my foam tape at the back of my panel. As my card base, I went with pink, the same pink cardstock that I used for the flowers. And now I'm going to pop on top the sentiment again with some foam tape. To finish off my card, I'm going to add some crystal gems at the center of some of the flowers. Just like always, you will find links to everything I used linked down the description area. Here are some close-up photos of the card that I made for today while playing with the latest foiling kit by Spellbinders. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired, and I'll see you all next time.